We're back in the news with this stupid frickin' shit, and that's the Harry Potter books are being removed Potter! Again. They're being removed again for on a Catholic school's exorcists advice.
Can I just say something? As a recovering Catholic myself.
Yeah, please.
As a recovering Catholic myself.
Yes.
If the Catholic school thinks that what they need to be worried about is the Harry Potter books.
No shit.
I've never seen such a sleight of hand.
And they have not read these books.
Of course not. Or if they have, it's still like, don't just worry about the priests that in your school that are raping the children.
Right. Exactly.
Yeah. Prioritize that.
Or they could do that, you know, what they did with those priests, like the Vatican actually moving around the priests from one church to the other so they don't get caught. So they could just move the books from one bookstore to the other one and it'd be fine.
Well, I know they got really bent out of shape by Hermione turning herself into a cat using the dark arts of the devil, you know, or that friendly ghost that comes through the wall and gives the kids advice, you know, is that's really upsetting them.
You know what's so weird, though? I remember when I was in Catholic school in elementary school. They would play as cartoons of like Adam and Eve and all the, you know, the stories.
Those documentaries.
And one of the videos they would play is how rock and roll is of the devil. And so they would go through everything from the Beatles to Queen and play stuff backwards. Like, you know how Another One Bites the Dust backwards is like, I want to smoke marijuana and things like that. It's the dumbest thing. Like, music and art doesn't cause any violence.
No.
It's people that do that.
There's
a
lot of wand shootings out there. Yeah. How much dark magic is fucking up this
country? Can you imagine? Can you imagine?
All these people dressing up as fucking Dementors and Voldemort's followers. Just fucking
can you imagine?
Christian in for the kill.
Oh my God.
We're taking your AR-15 and giving you a wand.
I'm out.
Wand drop.
I don't get this. I don't know why that we have to keep going back to Harry Potter. It's just because of the witchcraft thing and
it's just funny too, but the concept of that, because it's funny that it's not funny. It's actually sad that witches were burned back in the day only because it's just female empowerment, right?
It was just
females being weird. It's like, oh, you're not acting like you're supposed to act and just stay in the kitchen. And it's like, you're a witch. You got to be burned. Like, that's what witchcraft comes from.
Yeah.
There is no such thing. I mean, I hope there's spells and stuff. I'm still trying to hex, but I don't think it's possible.
You have witchcraft. You know.
It's bleeding. Yeah. It's bleeding. Burn it. It's bleeding. Burn it.
Exactly.
Yeah, basically that.
But so
I want to look, what is that? Roka, do you have that up?
What's
you
that?
Can actually see some of this. What are the reasons?
That's Ollivander. I worked for him.
Yeah, you sure did. Okay, thank you. Local paper, the Tennessean.
Yes, it's the Tennessee. It's
reported
Tennessee.
That the pastor of St. Edward Catholic School, which teaches children of pre-kindergarten age through the eighth grade, had emailed parents about J.K. Rowling's series to tell them they have been in contact with several exorcists who had recommended removing the books from the library. These books present magic as both good and evil, which is not true, but in fact a clever deception. Mm-hmm. The curses and spells used in the books are actual curses and spells.
Yeah.
My favorite is Engorgio, because it makes things bigger. Get it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Wingardium Leviosa is an actual spell, by the way, which when read by a human being risks conjuring evil spirits into the presence of the person reading the text.
Conjuring evil spirits.
Yeah.
Wow. That's...
Yeah,
that's.
I have no words.
What are these people doing though, with their lives? This is what they're scared about.
This pops up every few years, and it's just these people who want to get more
control over other
more people into their congregations. So they create what's the most popular thing going on. Let's vilify, put the devil on it, and then we'll get people to come join us, and we'll rely on your. Lack of intelligence to get you in here. They do that. They know what they're doing. They know exactly.
Well, it's not even intelligence.
Yeah.
I think it's just ignorance, and it's sad. And they take advantage of these people that aren't as educated, and it's very sad. And I used to go to mass every Sunday and hear about how you know women are lesser than men and homophobia and all this horrible things.
Even more
than that. But then they're saying Harry Potter, a book that teaches to be a good person, is a bad book. That makes no sense.
Right. Even more than that, when you were in those masses, you didn't see any women.
doing anything as part of that mess.
Right.
No, that only kneeling and standing up and doing
but
this
there was,
and doing this.
Maybe a woman could do a How reading. Dare you? Maybe she could be in the choir. Maybe. But that is like a huge blind spot,
well,
too.
Well, no, because women also, are just virgins.
There's also a lot of religious undertones in the Harry Potter series.
So right, yeah.
Like, there's a lot of great things within that whole series that could teach kids about great things. But,
oh, yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Absolutely. Those are some of my favorite books. Oh. They really are.
They're, also, they got kids excited about reading.
Can you... When was the last
when
time
is reading bad?
You saw a line around a corner yep. at a bookstore?
Yeah.
I mean, these things were events. I mean, yep. I remember getting Goblet of Fire and being like, wait, I have to wait in line? What the hell is going on?
We were running... I was at a summer program the one summer that the sixth or maybe the fifth or sixth book was getting released. And we actually, because we wanted the kids to be with us and in the summer, we had to, like, they all, like, left mm-hmm. to go get the book. Or their parents were shipping it to them or whatever. And we're like, okay, Harry Potter's still going to be there at the end of the summer, but your friends won't. So, but, like, I mean, how crazy to have to ask kids not to read during their summer camp.
Yeah.
Like, yeah. I like camp. But,
so I don't weird. Get it. In the next sentence in this article breaks my heart. It's they were on the shelves of the library, and then they created a new library, and they're off the shelves now. So, I mean, you go into this library, and you can't get a book that you might want to read because it's evil spirits are conjured with mm-hmm. Wingardium Leviosa. I can't believe it. I must be possessed now.
That's just in the high school library, correct?
I think so, yeah.
Now, if a kid in that school is carrying a Harry Potter book, you know, what's going to happen to them? Are they going to—
That's a good question, Christian.
Well, they'll need an exorcist.
Okay. They'll need an exorcist.
Can we bring an exorcist here to interview?
Dude.
Yes!
Yay! I'm so excited.
How do we
the
do that?
The producer said yes.
But here's the thing, though. We'd have to be very respectful, Dorina.
Yeah. Dorina. When am I not respectful?
This exorcist is going to walk in the room, see Dorina, go, nope.
Walk out. We'd have to be very respectful.
What if we brought him to exorcise me?
That's fine. Yeah. But then you'd be cleansed? I don't know.
Yeah, do you want that?
No.
Okay.
Are you watching Los Espookies?
Yes, it's so good.
Christian, are you watching this?
No, what is that?
It's great.
It's on HBO. Los Espookies.
Oh, fuck,
it's all in Spanish. Mm-hmm. Fred Armisen is one of the executive producers. We started just randomly the other night. Mm-hmm. This thing is funny as fuck.
Yes, it is.
You got to watch this.
I think it's my favorite new show of this year. That's a new show that I've never seen before. I really, really enjoy it.
They talk about Exorcist. They just do all this kind of stuff, setting up horror and evil things in this like community. And it's very funny, interesting characters. It's just a very brilliant, quiet
show. And it's funny because it's like...
I hear this more and more,
so
I got
to
see it.
Because it's kind of like they have like Ghostbusters-type stories, but then it's combined with like sort of telenovela humor, right?
Yes.
So
okay.
It's really great.
Oh, I love that. Okay. Just I want to check that out.
Yeah. Well, so they'll probably ban it at some point.
aside from not banning Los Espookies.
They're like, well, Slimer is going to kill us. So.
They're talking that devil language, that Spanish. Nope, can't have it.
Gozer the Carpathian. That is a definite...
State Bus Marshmallow Man is the devil.
Oh, totally. Totally. So, well... Harry Potter, that thing will blow over. I'm sure J.K. Rowling went, oh, another one. Okay, move on.